kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. And now it's time for the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Stanford is ready to open this one up as they line up for the opening kick. And down he goes at the 17-yard line. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Tackle at the 12-yard line.
The defense was just all over that play. It didn't fool anybody.
Second down, 15 to go. Ball on their own 12. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete.
Pratty drops the ball here. I don't know if he's starting to peek downfield and think about the return or what, but that ball's right in his hands. He just dropped it.
And he's tackled at the 48-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Quick pass. Tackle made at the 26. What a great play.
This is the timing that we talked about in the pregame that they must have in order to be successful at their passing game. That time the quarterback threw it to a spot and his receiver was there to make a nice grab.
From the 26-yard line, it's first down. And he's taken down right around the 26-yard line. To his receiver, no good. Boy, would he like to have that one back.
Yeah, you're right. This offense relies so much on timing, and as you saw there, when their timing gets knocked off, they have a tough time connecting on plays like this.
And they make the stop right around the 14-yard line.
Great effort here by the wideout to secure the ball and pick up some extra yardage.
First and 10. Ball on the 14. It out to about the 14-yard line. Nothing there on the keeper. Well, Kirk, we saw this kid head to the locker room a little bit earlier with that injury. Now we see he's back on the sideline. That's good news. Looks like he should be able to get back in the action. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. So the draw of the halfback picks up four. So it's another third down upcoming here. Wide open to the tight end, and he let it go through his hands. Stanford could take the lead with this field goal. Kicks up. And it sails through the uprights.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
They line up to kick this one away. to the 20. Gets out to about the 21. Stanford's looking right now like they've got all three phases working for them so far.
Yep, it's early, but they are in control of this game. The defense seems to have a very good feel for what they're doing out there. The offense moved the ball down the field. Special teams, everything right now is really in sync for this team.
And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Well, they run it left and a nice tackle right there.
That's a great play by the defense. There's nothing like a defense being able to slip off of a block, get into the backfield of the offense, and then make a play in the backfield to be able to create some momentum possibly for this defense.
Now he's scrambling. Brought down at about the 21. From their own 21-yard line, third down. He'll get it again. Nice run to the left there.
You know, great effort here by the ball carrier, but I think they need to pass in that situation most of the time.
He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. And he muffed it.
I'll tell you, a few plays in football can test your concentration like returning punts. You got to see the ball into your hands while not worrying about being hit.
And I'll tell you, in a close game like this, you just can't do stuff like that. The quarterback leads his squad back out. They got three on their last possession. Stanford holds a field goal lead. They'll bring him down right around the 30. From their own 30-yard line. Second down. Catches it, and that's all. He ran a good-looking route and picked up positive yardage.
That he did, and he made a good catch. That short passing game is where you see all those hours in the summer that you put in pay off.
Gets it out to about the 47-yard line.
Super effort by the tailback to pick up a nice gain and a first down. He's really a good-looking ball carrier.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 47. They're packed in tight on the line. Runs it right. Nice pickup. 7 yards there on that bit of misdirection. Chains.
Well, that's a strong run. It makes a statement when you can run the ball like that.
There are three quarters remaining. Stanford's got a three-point lead. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. Shot to the open receiver, and he can't hang on to the ball. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 39. Stanford is up by three. Delivers to the halfback on the screen. He's tackled around the 35-yard line.
Good work here by the defense to keep him from making something more out of that play.
Third down again.
Roger, Roger. Check 59. Mike is 59.
Swings it out left to the halfback. And down he goes at the 28.
The offense only got the first down by about a yard, but I'm sure they'll be happy with a new set of downs.
And this is the ninth play of the current drive. Throws this one away. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 28-yard line. Another run. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. And this is the 11th play of the current drive. Looks like they're going to try for the long field goal. The kick is up, and he nails the long field goal. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He'll return it from the 4-yard line. He's tackled at the 27-yard line. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. It's second down, 5 to go. Ball on the 32-yard line.
Mike 17, Mike 17. Greg Gillis.
Nice run, and he's brought down.
That makes it first and 10.
He's at midfield. And he's tackled right around the 48-yard line. From the 48-yard line. First down. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
Gain of 6 yards. That brings him second and 5.
Taken down at the 42. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about 4. Now he tries to buy some time. Tackle at the 28-yard line. First down, and he's out of bounds.
That makes it first and 10.
Here's the 8th play of the series. A huge play, and now they're in a great position to score. First and goal from the 3. Let's see if they can muscle this one in.
It's a great job here by the quarterback of recognizing the outside linebacker blitz and delivering the football for a first down.
Touchdown, Badgers! They'll try to tack on the extra point that will take the lead. And he adds the extra point. A 9-play, 72-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. The score now, 7-6. Wisconsin gets set to kick this one away. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
I give the defense credit, but right now I think it's more a case of sloppy offense.
Yeah, you got to recognize that both defenses have come into this game with the right mindset. They're very well prepared. But I'm with you. It's one thing to have great defense. It's another thing when those defenses are going up against offenses that just are not clicking right now and hitting on all cylinders.
Quick throw to the tight end. Tackle made right around the 36-yard line.
from their own 36-yard line. First down. Gets it out to an open receiver and just dropped it. About 4 yards away here on third down. Makes the first down catch. That's a great tackle at the 45-yard line.
He had a couple of freight trains coming at him, but when they blitzed, it created a hole in the coverage, and they took advantage of it. Defenders are really going to have to get their heads into this game. That was big play, and on first down, no less.
From the 28-yard line, it's first down. He's going to try and scramble. And he's taken down around the 21-yard line. Fires out to his receiver. Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal.
Big goal.
That makes it first and goal.
Let's go. Green, that's Thunder.
And they make the stop at the one.
That brings him second and goal.
Here's play number 10 on the drive. Kirk, we saw this guy head to the locker room a little bit earlier. Good to see him back on the sideline, and it looks like he could be returning to the game. Touchdown, Cardinal. Nice run and a score by the halfback.
And a nice call by the coach there. Just give it to your main man anytime you're near the goal line.
You knew that that touchdown was going to be won or lost in the trenches. And he converts the extra point. A nice 10-play, 73-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brett, I thought the key to that drive really had a lot to do with the quarterback and the receivers getting in sync, making it very tough for the defense to slow them down.
So the score now, 13-7. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He'll return it from the three, and he's taken down at the 19-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Makes it to the 22-yard line. Low-scoring first half of play, but a close game. Stanford leads it 13-7.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Take a look at both quarterbacks in this game, and neither one of them even has their pants dirty. Nobody's been on the ground here. No pressure generated by the defense, but one of the reasons is because quarterbacks have been able to get rid of the football. Maybe a little help in the secondary to those guys trying to rush the pass.
The guys up front always get the blame, but it really is a business that works hand in hand, because you can get a lot of sacks off garbage sacks where it's great coverage down the field, but the quarterback has to hold it for 4 or 5 seconds. But it works the other way around too. If somebody's open every time he pats that football and reaches the top of his drop, I can't get there in time. So the coverage needs to tighten up a little bit, mess up the rhythm, jam the receivers maybe a little bit more. Give me a little bit of time so those big boys up front can get to the quarterback.
I can only hope that Nessler and Herbstreit will bring the same type of intensity to their call of the second half that David and I brought to the halftime show. Of course, they always do. That's it for us here in the studio. Time to get you back out to the guys for the second half.
Great first half of a tight ball game, and we're set to start quarter number three.
He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Boy, this has been a fun game to watch, going back and forth and back and forth. It's almost like watching a tennis match here. Whoever has the ball last, my guess, will be the team that wins it.
It's a new possession for this offense, so what will it hold?
Stanford with a six-point lead.
That he lost the ball, he's got to forget about it and get ready for the next series. His offense is going to need him again.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure, but they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
And he makes it out to about the 24-yard line.
Second down and nine to go.
Ball on the 24-yard line. Crosses across the middle to his tight end. Brought down around the 14-yard line.
Makes it out to about the 11-yard line.
The back gets three on the carry.
And there's not much he could do to get away from the junior safety on that play.
Second down and seven coming up here. Ball on the 11-yard line. He fights forward to about the 10.
Throws this one away.
It's fourth down.
They're going to go for the easy three here. He gets it up, and he got it.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
Wisconsin lines up for the kickoff. Excellent kick. Tackle made at the 21. So the Badgers have really surprised everybody in this football game.
They have not been intimidated at all, which is great to see. The attitude and effort of this team's put them in a position where they got a shot to win this game here in the second half.
This offense lost the ball by way of a fumble the last time they had it.
You don't change your philosophy after one play. They'll be out doing the same thing as before, just with better awareness.
And he just gets rid of it. Second down, 10 yards to go.
Ball on the 21-yard line. Stanford has a three-point lead.
Throws it in a hurry.
They'll bring him down at the 34-yard line.
Flag down, and I'm not sure when it was thrown. Let's find out.
Offense.
That one's going to put him way back.
You just can't block a player from behind like that, or it's going to cost you.
So it's second down and long now after the penalty.
Defenders continue to exploit the O-line like that, it's going to be a long day for this running back.
Going deep, lays it out there. Missed him.
Number 98 was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it fourth and long.
And this one is a beauty. Tackle at the 46. He did a good job there to give his team decent field position. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Slings it. He's tackled around the 36-yard line. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. Makes the grab and steps out right away.
I credit the quarterback on that pass. He made a great read and delivered a very nice pass for the first down.
So it's second down now. They need about 4 yards to pick up the first. And down he goes at the 5-yard line. Just inside the five. It's second down. The lineman got a little ahead of the snap count. Here's the call.
False start. Offense.
That penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, if they could just keep their concentration, they'll avoid situations like that.
Decent run up the gut.
That makes it third and goal.
It's third and goal, and they're about 4 yards out. Touchdown, Wisconsin. The PAT. A 7-play, 52-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points. They line up to kick this one away. From his own goal line, he makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. He fights forward to about the 23. From their own 23-yard line, second down.
Maybe after a nice run like that, you try to go up in the air for the play-action pass.
He gets out to about the 42-yard line. And it looks like this one's going to come down to the final quarter. Wisconsin's up by 4. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. He's taken down around the 44-yard line. That makes it third down now, and they need to get it out to the 50.
screen pass. He's got his halfback. Tackle at the 48-yard line. You don't need three guesses to figure out what they're going to run right here on fourth and short. There's a very impressive open field tackle. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 42-yard line. Number 8 on the drive.
You know, these backwards plays can have a psychological impact. It can damage a team's confidence if it keeps happening.
Third down, and they need to get it down to the 32. Here's the 11th play of the drive. He steps out at the 24.
Not that impressive of a play. Let's see if they continue to employ the short passing game or if they decide to run the ball.
It's second down, 8 to go. Ball on the 24. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Green here, and the halfback's got it. And he's tackled at the 7-yard line.
Excellent job by this young quarterback of making the defense pay for bringing both outside linebackers. That's composure right there.
So here we go. First and goal, and a field goal won't cut it. Made around the 6-yard line. Here's play number 14 of this drive. And he is drilled at the 3. So here we go. It's 3rd and goal from the 2-yard line.
Big hit on the quarterback. That's one of those, as an offensive lineman, when the film study starts to come around, you're going to kind of sink in your chair and just hope they don't call you out, because you're going to get embarrassed on Monday. I think they had to go for it given the circumstances. They just couldn't pull it off.
9 times out of 10, the defense will make a stop on that play. But, you know, based on the situation, this offense did have to go for it. A score here might effectively end this one. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Gets to about the 14-yard line. And the halfback carries for a pickup of 3.
One thing about this linebacker over the years that separates him from the rest are his instincts and ability to make the play. That's a nice tackle by the senior.
Taken down as he works the left for a nice game. Stanford's going to have to use their second time out of the half. So it's 3rd down, and they've got about 2 yards to go.
Let's go.
huge stop right there here late in the fourth quarter in a game this tight. That might be one we look back on later and say that won the ball game. They're coming after this punter. Booming kick. Gets to about the 47-yard line. Stanford's ranking, that doesn't mean anything right now.
Now, they've not played up to their expectations at all, but they have the football here late in the game. They're very fortunate to still have a chance to maybe win it because they've not looked like themselves.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. From their own 47-yard line. Second down. He airs it out. Can't connect.
Boy, that was a rocket. If the receiver didn't come down with it, the quarterback made sure nobody else was going to come down with it either.
Stop at the 44. Under a minute left in the game. Wow, what a battle and what a stop right there. Congratulations to that defense. That's going to be the ball game. This might be it. They've got the lead, but if they add to it, they know they've got a victory. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. The offense lining up in a victory formation, and he takes a knee. From their own 41-yard line, it's second down.
Dog four, orange three, orange three.
And he'll just take a knee here to kill the clock. Great game to watch. Both teams should be proud of their efforts in this one. 17-13, Badgers. That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.